Hey, it's me, Dr. G, and welcome back to Friday Morning Rounds. I had an awesome show this week that addressed the broad implications of snoring. Check out my Facebook page or website for the full replay. Huge shout out to my longtime friend and colleague, Dr. Stephen J. Craftsman, MD, board certified otolaryngologist at Drs. Gerges and Associates. His insight and perspective were crucial to the discussion about what needs to happen now to reduce and or eliminate snoring for you, your bed partner, or other loved ones. Check him out at www.gergesent.com and read more about the latest diagnostic and therapeutic treatments for snoring. I went through a lot of myths versus facts on my show the other day, but I did not get through all of them. So I thought that I would take the time now to answer some more frequently asked questions as they relate to snoring. Here it goes. Is it true that drinking cocktails is especially bad for snorers? My answer is yes. Alcohol causes a sedative effect, leading to decreased muscle tone and increased upper airway collapse, which leads to snoring. Is it true that spritzing with a saltwater nasal spray before bed can open up passages? My answer is no. Nasal moisturizing is almost always a good thing, especially in winter, but probably would not help snoring. Is it true that older people snore more? My answer is yes. Snoring can worsen with age due to progressive obesity, decreased muscle tone, and redundant soft tissue. Is it true that snorers should record their daily habits to get insight into certain behaviors that are triggering snoring? My answer is yes. We do not do enough of this. If there are things that we can identify in our daily lives that contribute to the promotion of upper airway resistance and tissue collapsibility, then we need to rectify the situation. Is it true that when you are dehydrated, your mouth and nose can become sticky with secretions, this leading to more snoring? My answer is this is a chicken egg situation. Mouth breathing and snoring may actually cause dryness. Is it true that all snorers should avoid using sleep aids? My answer is that it depends. There is no blanket policy here, pun intended, but the fact is that sleep aids cause an effect similar to that caused by alcohol, leading to decreased muscle tone and more upper airway collapse that further exacerbates snoring. Is it true that everyone who snores has obstructive sleep apnea and that everyone who has obstructive sleep apnea snores? My answer is no. There is certainly a good correlation between the two, but in cases of central sleep apnea, it may be different. I will do two more of these and then give you my closing points about snoring. Is it true that snoring means you are in deep sleep? My answer is no. Snoring may occur during deep sleep, but it is not a normal function of deep sleep. And lastly, is it true that side sleepers snore less? My answer is probably yes. Let me leave you with my call to action. If you have been told that your snoring is disturbing to others, or you have some of the symptoms and signs that indicate snoring, please consult your doctor. He or she will take your history, perform a physical exam, and determine whether you require a consultation with an otolaryngologist. Prepare to go for a sleep test to make sure that you do not have obstructive sleep apnea, and additionally, to see how your snoring affects your sleep quality. After taking these key steps, you will learn about various treatment approaches available, along with their chances of success, possible complications, and costs. As I tell all my patients who snore, I want them to find the best strategy that is correct for them to move forward with treatment and to finally sleep better again. Peace out.